we don't even know where the lungs came from. We don't even know how old the person was.
Gender.
We don't know anything. But we know they signed their card and they gave that gift.
Mm-hmm.
And it's meant so much for our family.
I think as a parent, like, the worst news that you can get is that your child has like months to live. That was very, very difficult.
Her health was in grave danger and that she might only last a few months.
I asked, what's the average wait time for lungs? And they said 18 months. You know, and then right before they had told me a couple days ago she had months to live, so I'm thinking in my head, okay, like, this clearly is not a very good situation.
She lost consciousness, and she's, you know, she said, I can hear, but I can't see. And so then we were back in the emergency case in the middle of the night. This procedure, which had never been done at sick kids before, and only a few other times in the world was it done, but never on a child. They could put Katie on this Novalung.
Her life is just hanging on by a thread, just a little tiny thread. Anything could just, you know, and it would be over. Every single breath was just,
yeah.
Come on, Katie, you can do it. Just another breath, just one more breath, you can do it.
And so they rushed her to the elevator and rushed her down to the OR.
We were told that when she was on the Novalung that her heart, which had gotten quite large, deflated like a balloon. That's how they described it to us. Like,
fortunately, they were successful in, you know, getting her on the Novalung.
Less than 1% of the population dies in a way that you can preserve the lungs. Only 3% of that 1% has lungs that are suitable for transplant. Of that, it has to be the right blood type. Basically, it's like almost...
It's a needle in a haystack.
The first indication that there was might be a match for her. And I can remember feeling like such relief, like, okay, like, you know, we're gonna move on with this, we're gonna get the lungs, she's gonna get better, she's gonna come home. And then the doctors come in and say, you know, we are really sorry. These aren't the lungs for her.
So the fourth time,
yeah.
I got the call in the middle of the night, and it always happens in the middle of the night. So they were very, very positive about this set of lungs. And so I went to Katie's bedside and I said, Kate, they found some lungs for you and they think they're really good. And she said, Dad, I don't want to play this game anymore. And then we got the news. Shortly after that, that the lungs, it was a go.
Like, you see life in a different way, I guess, because before, everyone just takes life for granted until something like that happens to you, so.
Every day's a gift. And just be thankful for each day, because you don't know what, you know, it's gonna happen tomorrow, so.
No matter how bad anything seems, like, there's always hope. You know, stay positive, positive thinking.
The doctors there say that it's a miracle she's here.
It was just like such a delicate balance that needed to occur in order for Katie to be here right now.